Hello everybody, for another Milan jersey, and yeah, this is already my 7th video on AC Milan jerseys. You see, I have quite a lot, and this is actually my 6th ever jersey in the 7th video. I should have planned this better, but yeah, 98-2000 AC Milan home jersey, the first one since 93 made by Adidas again, and yeah. That's the one they won the championship in 99 in, the centenary season. So this was in a way, it was not really the centenary jersey, but this was the jersey they wore in the centenary season. And if you've seen my previous, the 96-97 one and this one, I was actually quite disappointed. I like the design. This is the same as the Real Madrid jersey from the same time. It's just not as shiny. It has the same color. The color actually is quite nice, but it's not as visible. What I never liked is that this is actually not Milan striping hardcore, this is FC Barcelona striping. And yeah, also that the red stripe is at the center. Back at the time I thought the black stripe always has to be in the center. This was sacrilegious in a way. And if you look at it now, it still seems like a red jersey with two black stripes, but what saves it is that actually the arms are also red and the black is here on the bottom, so this is actually gives it a little bit more of a black and red look than just by purely looking at it. And also what I like is that nowadays it is more red. After that, the Adidas made a lot of Milan shirts where black was a dominant color. This is more red. For that it gets already a little bit more classic look to me. It's similar to this shirt. I mean, this is the really the classic Milan striping, the first ever Milan jersey had this striping with, but this is also a little bit more red than black, and this also very even between black and red, but since the shoulders are red and this black is only on the side here, it doesn't seem as black but more red. What I really would like to have seen is that here in the color, like with the Real Madrid, they have a little Real Madrid logo there. Maybe should have made it here an ACM or something a little bit more. But on that same material, this one I actually got off eBay about 10 years ago. I really was looking for this jersey, and I got it, and I got it for a relatively good price. It had its little bubbles here and there. I don't know if you can see. It's very hard to make out. Yeah, here you know, it has a few pulls. It has been worn, but I actually think it's in overall really good shape. What was important for me at the time, when I got this, I didn't have a red and black jersey with the Milan crest. If you saw my video yesterday, this was a big thing for me. Now, and it was in a way, I couldn't get a nice looking Milan shirt with a Milan crest, and then I saw this one and yeah, I had to get it. They were champions in this one. I would like to get the third jersey that they won the championship in Perugia in, the black one with the three red stripes. That's one that's pretty near to the top of my list of jerseys. The other one would be, of course, the centenary shirt. Really nice jersey now. When I look at it, I like the piping here that actually splits the black here again. The back is plain. Of course, I would like to have, I think Shevchenko was not yet in the team, but this was Bierhoff's team. This was the first time that they had more Germans than Dutch. And one big thing when I got a Milan Fender, it was, you know, the Dutch were the dominant and Inter was the German team. And of course, love the Dutch, as you will see very soon. And yeah, so then they had three Germans, and this seemed weird to me, but I remember this was kind of my final test. Am I a Milan fan, or if they have too many Germans, will I not like Milan? It turned out I'm a Milan fan, and yeah, Ziege didn't play that much. Lehmann also was an afterthought, and it was all about Oliver Bierhoff, and he scored the goals, and I still remember him fondly. I think that frontline with VR and Bierhoff, that's a pretty cool one. And this is a pretty cool shirt. if I would get ever a number on there, it's very hard to look past Maldini, and I have already three Maldini shirts, so it's very hard to look past Maldini. I think at this time Maldini was almost in his prime, I would say. Milan was not the top team, but I think Maldini at that time was in his prime. Also, look at the lining here, ACM. The sleeve cuffs are also quite nice in a way. Overall, a really nice shirt. I don't wear it that often anymore, but I have some good memories, and maybe I'll pull it out of the bag. Also, the last thing, the sponsor is now kind of, it's this, how to say, plastic fabric that is a little bit raised, that's glued on there, which, yeah, is not as great as the print. You cannot, but yeah, you can see it here on the close-up, the L slightly raised. It's not as much as the Tottenham shirt that I have, or the Real Madrid shirt, and I thought that back then this is the perfect way to put the sponsor. These things, when you wash them too often, they come off. This is kind of sturdy because the lettering is not as crazy. But I read the Real Madrid, the Teca with the long T, that came completely off and I had to glue it back on. Well, let me know what you think about this jersey. If you have any memories with it, do you like it or not? I mean, well, this is among my more favorite Milan jerseys, although I don't wear it that often. Give me a thumbs up if you like this video, and subscribe to my channel if you want to see more of these, and I will talk to you soon. If you enjoyed this video, please hit like and subscribe to my channel. If you've already done so, I would like to thank you for your support. It is very much appreciated. Also, check out the accompanying blog at the link provided in the description below and at the end of this video. Thank you for watching, and until next time.